modern bikes aside, we all miss a bit of the rawness that draws us back to vintage machines. The board trackers, hill climbers, and flat track racers of the 20s, 30s, and 40s are stunning. Perhaps we are old-fashioned, but in our minds, a proper Indian is a racer. Purpose-built competition machines, utilizing only the barest of necessities. If there were tar roads in the Old West, this bike would be perfect, just like a fish in water. Almost everything seems to be old, even with the flavor of modernity on these wheels. It seems to be from an old era, in which the main vehicles consumed straw, and the driver's seat was called saddle. The era that reminds us someone called Clint Eastwood. Welcome to Racer TV. Indian Chieftain is a big motorcycle designed to soak up the miles on the smooth highways of Murica. The remarkable good-looking motor caught the eye of Roland Sands, the man who can do no wrong when it comes to creating genre-bending customs. But the real inspiration came from a drag bike rendering that Sylvan from Holographic Hammer sent to him. And thus was born this project called the Track Chief. This single-side rigid frame is a masterpiece, hugging the engine just so. The girder fork was also an amazing challenge. Considering it was a rigid with a leaf fork, Roland Sands had nightmares about how it was going to handle. But in the end, it couldn't have turned out better. The compression and rebound dampening of the shock is a perfect match to the rate of the leaf spring. Sitting above the frame is a hand-fabricated titanium tank. Yes, I said titanium. Which is also the material of these exhaust pipes. This isn't the kind of machine that will find its way back into Indian's catalog. But the burgeoning cool factor of America's oldest motorcycle brand just stepped up a notch or three. We'll be right back. This machine demonstrates what Daniel Moore said once. Technology over technique produces emotionless design. Thank you for watching Racer TV. And as always, I hope to see you next week.